Hello students, how are you? I hope you all will be fine. Today there is some problems, so I cannot give the lecture on board. Okay, so today I'll just make you understand some terms related to rational numbers with the help of book only. So what is a rational number? First of all, I think we have done this in your previous class also, like the fractions. Okay, so rational number, what is in a rational number? Rational number is in a form of the fraction. A rational number is in a form of p upon q, or you can say there is one numerator and the denominator, but there is one term, denominator never equal to zero. Okay, so before discussing about the rational numbers, we must know these terms, like the natural numbers, whole numbers, integers and fractions. So what are the natural numbers? As you all know, you have done this in previous class also, the natural numbers, the counting numbers are called the natural numbers that start from 1. Okay, natural number starts from 1. Okay, 1, 2, 6 up to infinity, all are the natural numbers. Now the whole numbers. Whole numbers are the natural numbers with the 0. Means in the whole numbers we will add 0 also. All natural numbers together with 0 are called the whole numbers. 0, 1, 2, 6 up to infinity. All are the whole numbers. Okay. So we can say all natural numbers are the whole numbers, but all whole numbers are not the natural numbers, because 0 is extra in the whole numbers, that is not in the natural numbers. Now the integers. What are the integers? Integers are the all natural numbers 0. And negatives of counting numbers are called the integers. Means all natural numbers 0 and negative of the counting numbers. Simply we can say all positive numbers, all negative numbers and 0, all are the integers. Okay, so here some examples are given, like these are the negative numbers, this is 0, and these are the positive numbers. So these negative numbers are called the negative integers, and this is 0, this is separate, and these are the positive integers. 0 neither negative nor positive, ye na to negative mein hai na positive mein hai. All are the integers. So these are the positive integers. I has told you these are the negative integers. 0 is a integer which is neither positive nor negative. Okay, now clearly a positive integer is same as an natural numbers. Theek hai, so positive integer means all the natural numbers. Okay, and if we are taking the 0 and the natural numbers, then we will say that are the whole numbers. So simply we can say all natural numbers comes under the integers, all whole numbers comes under the integers. Now the fraction. What is in a fraction? The numbers of the form a upon b, where a and b are the natural numbers. Natural numbers means positive, we are talking about the positive numbers, natural numbers, are called the fractions. Thus 2 upon 3, 3 upon 8, 11 upon 5, and this 102 upon 23, etc. All are the fractions. Means fractions we have done in the previous class. Fractions, in the fractions, numerator denominator both are positive, because they are saying these a and b, means numerator and denominator will be the natural number, and we know that natural numbers are the positive numbers only. Okay, so now what is the difference between the fraction and the rational numbers? Rational numbers, the numbers of the form p upon q, p upon q, this is any number. Okay, where p and q are integers. In the fractions, that are the natural numbers, means only the positive numbers, but in the rational numbers, that are the integers. Integers means that can be positive, negative. And q not equal to 0 means your denominator will never equal to 0. Why will never equal to 0? Because in the mathematics, if we will divide any number, suppose we are writing 3 upon 0. So this condition is not defined. This condition is not defined in mathematics. There is no solution for that. Okay. So we will not take denominator 0. That's why they have written q never equal to 0. This is the rational number. Now the examples of the rational numbers. Here are the rational numbers, means two types of rational numbers are there, positive rational numbers and the negative rational numbers. So each of the numbers 3 upon minus 4, minus 6 upon 17, minus 8 upon 3, minus 3, 2 upon 5, these all are the rational numbers. Why? Because denominator not equal to 0, condition is this, and these are the integers. So 0 is an irrational number. Ye rational number to hai. Since we can write 0, how we can represent 0 as an irrational number? We can divide 0 by the 1. So that will be the 0 upon 1, that is an irrational number. Okay. Which is quotient of two integers with a non-zero denominator. Means condition is this, numerator can be 0, but denominator will never equal to 0. Every natural number is an irrational number. Every natural number is an irrational number. So you have to write all these definitions in your notebook, in your FAIR notebook. What are the definitions? These are given in your book. Natural number, whole numbers, integers, fractions, rational numbers. Okay, up to here. After that, we can and the next point is, one is also can represent as an means third point they are saying, every natural number is an irrational number. Means every natural number means 1 to infinity, or we can say all positive integers. So all positive integers can be represented as an rational numbers like this. 1 we can represent 1 upon 1, 2 we can represent 2 upon 1, 3 we can represent 3 upon 1, and so on. The fourth point is, every integer is an rational number. How we can say every integer? Suppose we are having any integer, positive, negative, we can take any, okay, and 0 also. So if we are having 5, so we can write 5 upon 1, yes? So they are saying if m is an integer, m means any value, you can take any value, positive, negative or 0. Then we can write it as m upon 1, means hum usko 1 se divide kar sakte hain, yes, which is clearly a rational number. So next point is, your fifth point is, every fraction is an irrational number. Fraction is also a rational number, because in the fractions, all numbers are the rational numbers. Means jo hum fraction le rahe the, p upon q, or you can say a upon b always will be the natural number. So that will be the, so here they are saying every fraction is an a natural number. Okay, so let's a upon b is an a fraction, a upon b are the whole numbers, b never equal to 0. Bas condition you have to remember this condition, denominator never equal to 0. Okay, so positive rational numbers and the negative rational numbers. Positive rational numbers are the rational numbers that are having positive sign. Okay, but sometime the number that is having negative sign, that is also a positive rational number. How? Because we can cut this minus with minus, this minus with minus. So it will be positive. Or another way, how to recognize a number, whether that is in a positive rational numbers or in a negative rational numbers. There is a one definition, means a rational number is said to be a positive if its denominator and numerator and the denominator are either both positive or negative. Means either both, ya to numerator and denominator both will be positive or both will be negative. Only in this condition we can say our number is positive rational number. What about the negative rational numbers? In the negative rational numbers, either numerator or denominator, from that one will be negative. Means here, look at here, minus 3 upon 5. So here numerator negative, that means this complete number is negative. Here denominator negative, numerator negative, denominator. So these are the negative rational numbers. These are the negative rational numbers. Now one more thing that I want to tell you, equivalent rational numbers. What are the equivalent rational numbers? Suppose you are having any rational numbers. Suppose you are having 2 upon 3. Okay. So I want the equivalent rational numbers. If you will multiply numerator and denominator both with the same number, like I'm multiplying here 2 and this is also by 2. So what will be our answer? 4 upon 4 upon 6. Yes? So, means if you are multiplying or dividing numerator and denominator with the same number, then the resultant number will be the equivalent to the given number. Okay? Okay, like here we are using. First example is also given. Okay? Find 4 rational numbers equivalent to each of the following rational numbers. So, what will be the equivalent of the 3 upon 4? Means you will multiply the 3 upon 1 with the same number. So, first you are multiplying with the 2, then 3, then 4, then 5. Because here you have to find out 4 equivalent numbers. Okay. I hope you understand this. Now, let's move to our exercise. Our exercise is 4A. Okay. So, today we have to start this exercise. I will not give this complete exercise today. I will give you only up to question number 10. Remaining we will do in the next video lecture. So here 4A. What is the first question? What are the rational numbers? Give the example of 5 positive, 5 negative rational numbers. Is there any rational numbers which is neither positive nor negative? Name it. We have done this in definition. We have done the definition of the rational numbers. Yes, rational number is in a form of P upon Q, where Q never is equal to 0. An example of 5 positive. Positive means either both numerator and denominator will be positive or negative. Means ya to dono hi positive hoenge ya dono hi negative. So that will be our positive rational numbers. What about the negative rational numbers? In the negative rational numbers, either numerator or denominator, means one from them will be negative. So you can write any numbers for that. Another we have to tell, is there is any rational numbers which is neither positive nor negative? Yes, 0. 0 is an rational number that is neither positive nor negative. And name it. Name means 0. Now the question number 2. Which of the following are rational numbers? Here we have to tell which of the following are the rational numbers. So here this is rational number. This is rational number. This is also rational number. This is also rational number. 6. This is integer. This is integer, but we can convert this into rational numbers. Minus 3, this is an integer, but we can convert this into rational numbers, but this is integer. 0 is an a, 0 comes under integer, but we can convert this also in this 0 upon 1. What about this 0 upon 1? This is rational number. Why? Because numerator is not equal to 0. But this is not a rational number. Why? Because here denominator is 0. And we know that we cannot take denominator 0. Last is 0 upon 0. So this is also not a rational number. Yes, because we cannot take denominator 0. Now, question number 3. Write down the numerator and the denominator of each of the following rational numbers. What we have to do here? Write down the numerator and the denominator of each of the following rational numbers. Rational numbers are given. What is the numerator? The upper one is the numerator. This is our numerator. This is denominator. This is very simple. It will be numerator. This will be denominator. So what you have to do? You have to write like this. Numerator is equal to 5. And denominator is equal to minus 8. Like this. So you have to write all. What about this? This is 9. So we can write this 9 upon 1. So here numerator is 9. Denominator will be 1. Okay. Now question number 4. Write each of the following integers as an a. Rational numbers. Write the numerator and the denominator in each case. Write each of the following integer as a rational numbers. Means these are the integers. And we have to represent this as an a rational number. So what we will do? We will just divide all the integers by the 1. So first 5 upon 1, minus 3 upon 1, 1 upon 1, and this is 0 upon 1, and this is minus 23 upon 1. So that will be our rational numbers. Write the numerator and the denominator for each case. Then we have to write numerator and denominator. After converting this, so I'm doing this here. I'm doing this here, 5 upon 1. So this will be our numerator and this will be our denominator. Got it? Now the question number 5. Which of the following are the positive rational numbers? Positive. What is the condition for the positive? Either both will be the negative or both will be positive. So here this is negative because only denominator negative. This is negative. This is negative. We have to tell positive. So we will cross. This is negative. This is negative. This is positive because numerator and denominator both are negative. This is also positive. What about this? This is also positive. And what about 8? We can write 8 upon 1. So it will be also positive. Got. Which of the followings are the negative rational numbers? In the negative, from the numerator and denominator, only one will be negative. So here we have to tell negative means we will just tick the negative numbers. Hum negatives ko tick karenge. This is not negative. This is positive. What about this? This is neither negative nor positive. Zero to hamara negative or positive mein nahi aayega. Yes. So here also you can think about this. The answer will be zero. But this is given in fraction. That's why I told you. Sign, with the help of sign, this is positive. Yes, but answer will be zero, so it will not come in any category. Okay, check this from your backside also and in your examples also. So zero, neither negative nor positive, this will not come in the negative. Okay, cross this also. This is negative. Yes, this is negative. Yes. What about this? This is negative. And what will be the denominator? 1. This is also negative. Question number 5. Find 4 rational number equivalent to each of the following. Here we have to find out 4 rational numbers equivalent to each of the following. So I am doing here only 1 for you. Only 1 for you. Suppose I am having 6 upon 11. 6 upon 11. So what will be the equivalent of this? Another number will be 6 to the 12. 11 to the 22. What will be next number? 6 3 the 18. And 11 3 the 33. Like this. So you will write the table like this. Then 6 4 the 11 4 the 6 5 the 11 5 the like this. How many you have to find out? 4 only. 2 I have done. Remaining 2 you will do. And remaining you will do by your own. 8 upon 1 you will write, 1 upon 1 you will write here, and minus 1 upon 1 you will write here. Now your question number 8. Write each of the following as a rational numbers with the positive denominator. Means these are the rational numbers, but we have to write with the positive denominators. So how we will do the positive denominator? Look at here. Denominator is negative, but I want the positive. So 12, you can put this minus with that, or you can do this multiply with minus 1 and minus 1. So what will be that? Minus 12 upon 17, because minus minus will be plus. So the answer for this will be minus 12 upon 17. So now denominator is 17. That is positive. What about this? Minus minus will be cut. Minus minus will be cut. So it will be 8 upon 19. So now denominator is positive. What about this? You can write this sign ko aap upar likh sakte hain minus, because this minus, either this is here. आप इसको यहां भी लगा सकते हैं. यू कैन पुट दिस इज न्यूमिनेटर विद डिनोमिनेटर एंड यू कैन पुट दिस इन सेंटर. इट विल बी नेगेटिव. सो यू कैन राइट माइनस 11 अपॉन 6. सो नाउ डिनोमिनेटर इज पॉजिटिव. ओके, नाउ द क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 एंड 10. एक्सप्रेस दिस एज एन रैशनल नंबर्स विद डिनोमिनेटर. मीन्स वेट. Okay, I'm doing on the paper this. Okay, question number 9. What is the statement? We have to express 5 upon 8 as a रैशनल नंबर एज अ रैशनल नंबर विद विद न्यूमिनेटर विद न्यूमिनेटर इज इक्वल टू 15 एंड इन अनदर केस न्यूमिनेटर विल बी माइनस टेन. ओके सो वट वी आर हैविंग गिवन वट इज गिवन टू अस दिस इज आर सोल्यूशन नाउ वट इज गिवन टू अस दैट इज 5/8. आई वॉन्ट न्यूमिनेटर 15. न्यूमिनेटर मीन्स अपर वन. हाउ यू विल डू दैट? यू विल मल्टीप्लाई दिस विद 3 एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो 3. सो वट यू विल गेट? 5 3 15 एंड 8 3 24. सो नाउ हेयर इज न्यूमिनेटर 15. सो दिस इज आर आंसर. विद द अनदर वन वट यू विल डू? 5/8 इज गिवन. वी वॉन्ट द न्यूमिनेटर 10 दैट इज ओ माइनस. वी वॉन्ट माइनस. सो यू विल मल्टीप्लाई विद दिस -2. सेम यू हैव टू डू विद द डिनोमिनेटर. मीन्स इफ यू आर मल्टीप्लाइंग द न्यूमिनेटर विद एनी थिंग देन यू हैव टू डू सेम विद द डिनोमिनेटर ऑल्सो. सो वट वी विल गेट हेयर? 5 2 -10 एंड हेयर -16. सो दिस विल बी आर आंसर. नाउ द क्वेश्चन नंबर 10. वट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 10? एक्सप्रेस 4/7 एज एन रैशनल नंबर विद द डिनोमिनेटर. वट इज नंबर? क्वेश्चन नंबर टेन. नंबर इज 4/7. वी हैव टू रिप्रेजेंट दिस डिनोमिनेटर 21. वट इज द डिनोमिनेटर? डिनोमिनेटर शुड बी लिव इट 4/7. डिनोमिनेटर विल बी 21. ओके वन इज दिस. अनदर इज 4/7. डिनोमिनेटर विल बी -35. ओके न्यूमिनेटर वी डोंट नो. सो यू विल राइट लाइक दिस. आप ऐसे ही लिखेंगे इसको. सो वट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन दिस? 7 3 दिस इज 7 3. सो वी विल डू 4 3 दैट इज 12. सो वट इज आर आंसर? 12/21. हेयर 7 5 बट दैट इज नेगेटिव. सो 4 5 दैट विल बी नेगेटिव. 4 5 20. सो दिस विल बी आर आंसर. सो इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो आई विल गिव ऑन द बोर्ड बट टूडे यू हैव टू डू ओनली अप टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 10. ओके सो डू क्वेश्चन नंबर 1-10 इन योर रफ नोटबुक. ओके थैंक यू क्लास. हैव ए नाइस डे.